Good afternoon, dear students. So today I'm going to discuss about essay writing. So what is the importance of essay writing? So when you come across with higher studies, dear students, for example, let us take about International English Language Testing System. So in that we would be having also this essay writing. So essay writing plays a very important role. So you will be given so many essays and the different kinds of essays where you need to persuade sometimes and narrative and taking a stand and all. So there are so many types of essay writing, dear students. And let me tell you, even in the placement drives also, you would be asked to write essays also. So dear students, essay writing plays a very important role in education. So now, what is essay writing? So essay is a Latin word which has taken from essayum. Students, what actually an essay is? So an essay is a short piece of writing on a specific theme. So I repeat, it's a short piece of writing on a specific theme. See, and let me tell you, dear students, essay writing is completely personalized. So we'll be writing our experiences, our own perspective. See, perspective varies, dear students. So the essay writing will be according to the writer's perception. So now there are formal and also informal essay writings. So now if you see an essay writing, so we'll be having different parts in an essay writing. So like the beginning, the middle and the end. So for example, even we can say that the introduction or the thesis point of the essay and the body paragraphs of the essays and the conclusion. So when we go ahead, so I'll discuss this afterwards. And when we go ahead with the different types of essays, dear students, we have narrative, descriptive, expository and persuasive. When we see the topics or the titles of the essays, dear students, we should come to know that to what type that belongs. According to that, we should go ahead with our argument. So now let us discuss what is narrative kind of topic, essay writing topic. So narrative thing is something like you would be asked to narrate an incident that has happened in your life, or the happiest moment in your life, or an accident which you have seen. So like this, it goes in a narrative way, like where it would be in first person, and we should involve the readers also, so that that would be interesting, and we should make it as real, so the readers find interesting to read that particular kind of topics, narrative. So when we use this narrative, dear students, we should use certain words like initially, afterwards, so finally. So this will give us coherence and cohesion and also. So now let me talk about descriptive kind of essay. What is descriptive? So descriptive is nothing but to describe a place, to describe a personality. So it is nothing but in one word or in one sentence we can say it is painting a picture through words. So like explaining something. So how the height of a building. Let us take this classroom, like how it is, the size of it, the dimensions of it, the board, or chairs, tables, systems, how they are, and also we need to describe them. It is nothing but a painting, a picture. Okay, and then next goes expository kind of essays. So what is expository kind of essays? So like where we need to provide facts, truths, so information about this topic. So dear students, in this kind of expository topic, so we don't have that much of chance to take a side and to speak on that. So it doesn't have our own perceptions or the narrator's feelings and all. So mostly that would be like, dear students, cause and effect, contrasting and facts and all these things we need to explain, that is providing information on a particular topic. So where we do not have any scope to give our personal ideas or perceptions and all. So let us take Puzzle Essay Essay, which is very, very important, dear students. So this essays we will see mostly in IELTS examination. So dear students, when you choose this Puzzle Essay Essay, so we can take any stand, dear students, any side we can take, and what you can project both the ideas, both the arguments, both the sides you can talk, but you should prove and you should convince that the writer's argument has more weight. So we should be very, very careful, dear students, and we should be very, very diplomatic in giving out our argument and convincing others, persuading others that our perception has more weightage. Have you understood? And now when you go for guidelines for writing an essay, so don't start it vaguely or without any preparation or plan. So for example, when we talk about IELTS essay writing, we'll be following power plan, all these things. So likewise here, students, for any of the essay writing, so we need to think properly and follow the guidelines in order to make or write or draft or craft a beautiful essay. So now let us read some of the topics, like let us learn some of the things, like what we can do in order to craft a beautiful essay. So now, first, initially, what we should do? We should read the topic, that is the title of the topic. And next, what we need to do, dear students, we need to identify the keywords in the essay. So, for example, sometimes we may not be aware of the meaning of the keywords. At that time, what to do, dear students? We should refer a dictionary or something in order to know the meaning of the keywords. So then what? Identify the task. Like, what we are supposed to do is that should we describe the topic, or should we compare or contrast, or should we convince? Is it expository? We should identify the task that is given in the essay. So without that, we cannot plan what to do, dear students. So like ask, narrate, describe, and all. So now, taking a stand, for example, so whatever the topic is, we need to take a stand. For example, when it comes to persuasive essays and all, so we need to decide on what stand we will be. So what we support, so how we convince, how we persuade. So this we need to have an idea before you start an essay. So now, many of us will be bringing into picture the irrelevant points which are not connected to the essay. Students, be very, very careful, like on what issues we need to speak even in the given context. Okay, so things which are relevant to the topic should be only brought into picture, and all the unnecessary and the irrelevant points should be deleted. You should not include them. So we should see that we are focused to the point, or we are connected to the point. So keep it in mind and think very carefully and bring things into the picture which are connected to the topic. And now let me tell you, the most important thing is preparing an outline or a diagram. So before we write, so we need to prepare an outline, or you know, make a tree diagram or something before we attempt to write an essay. So like, what is that we make in that outline or diagram? Dear students, we should organize your thoughts. So let me tell you, dear students, coherence and cohesion plays an important role in writing essay. So organizing your thoughts, connecting them, so from the beginning to the end. So many of the students I see that they will be starting, even though you know the conclusion, and there are many similarities between the conclusion and the starting, but the starting is very different, dear students. We can start an essay with a quotation, with a shocking statement, with a short story, with an anecdote. So in order, with a proverb, with a statement, in order to gain the reader's attention, dear students. So in this way, we can start an essay writing effectively. So, and conclusion should be like, you know, it should support the overall essay and gives a concluding point. I know when you are organizing your thoughts and what you need to do, dear students, you need to jot down the points so that would be, you know, very helpful to you when you are, you know, writing an essay, like organizing the listing the main ideas. So like each main idea, we can explain it in one separate paragraph. So unity of thought is to be maintained, dear students, while we are writing an essay. So now, so in this way, listing out the main ideas and leaving some space to provide evidence to a topic is also very important. So in this way, we can prepare a diagram or an outline when you write an essay. And the next important point before we write an essay is nothing but, dear students, doing research. So doing research, referring to books, magazines, journals are very, very important, dear students. So now, because of the advancement of technology, internet is in our hands, dear students, and we can use internet, library and many of the sources, and we can take or make notes, dear students, and we can use codes, and if anything, if we repeat it, we can even acknowledge their codes and also students. So in this way, if you do a thorough research, so our essay would be very, very effective. And now I just would like to focus on brainstorming. So before we write an essay, so it is also that we need to have a brainstorming, like, you know what, so we need to have an idea, like on what topic we are going to write, and also it is that we need to support our ideas, main ideas, with the relevant evidences, and also we can use this mind mapping and all. So this helps us a lot while we are writing an essay. So, and developing a thesis. So thesis is a main point, what it should be a debatable and argumentative thing, like we should have more main idea in that. So developing a thesis is very, very important, students. So our introduction should be very effective. So we need to give the main body of the topic, and also the main body. So we can write the supporting ideas or the main ideas, what we have listed, main ideas, and that should be supported with the supporting details in our essay, students. So before we write what we could do, and we could also conclude it effectively, and yes, students, editing, drafting and making a final copy is very, very important when we go ahead with the essay writing. So dear students, so even though you think that essay writing is easy, but dear students, there are so many steps that we need to follow while we are making or writing an essay writing. Students, is this helpful for you? Is this helpful for you, dear students? So have you understood what I am trying to say, dear students? So essay writing plays a very, very important role in education, dear students. So we should be very, very careful while we write an essay writing. So almost in the IELTS exam and in in competitive exams also, I have forgotten to say. And when we go for this campus selections also, dear students, essay writing plays an important role. So we need to focus on some of the important things, like clarity of thought, dear students, unity is very, very important, coherence and cohesion. After writing this, students, after writing, so editing is very needed, what I say. So our sentences should be grammatically perfect, so, and we should organize them logically. So logical arrangement of the sentences are very, very important. So we should see that whether our essay is logically arranged or not, and we should end it with a good conclusion, dear students. These are some of the steps that we need to follow while we are writing an essay writing. So hope students, this has provided you with good information about essay writing. So the most important thing what you need to focus is to identify different types of topics. Dear students, the topics are narrative, descriptive, expository and persuasive. So basing on the topic, you need to select on which grounds these topics comes under. So according to them, so you should follow the pattern and you should go take a stand and you need to support your ideas. Have you understood what I'm trying to say, dear students? So in this way, we can go ahead and we can draft or craft a beautiful essay writing. Have you understood?